may be seated. Our scripture reading today comes from Psalm 51, verses 1 through 17. Hear now the word of the Lord. Have mercy on me, O God, according to your steadfast love, according to your abundant mercy, blot out my transgressions. Wash me thoroughly from my iniquity, and cleanse me from my sin. For I know my transgressions, and my sin is ever before me. Against you, you alone, have I sinned and done what is evil in your sight, so that you are justified in your sentence and blameless when you pass judgment. Indeed, I was born guilty, a sinner when my mother conceived me. You desire truth in the inner being. Therefore, teach me wisdom in my secret heart. Purge me with hyssop, and I shall wash me, and I shall be whiter than snow. Let me hear joy and gladness. Let the bones that you have crushed rejoice. Hide your face from my sins and blot out all my iniquities. Create in me a clean heart, O God, and put a new right spirit within me. Do not cast me away from your presence, and do not take your Holy Spirit from me. Restore to me the joy of your salvation, and sustain in me a willing spirit. Then I will teach transgressors your ways, and sinners will return to you. Deliver me from bloodshed, O God. O God of my salvation, and my tongue will sing aloud your deliverance. O Lord, open my lips, and my mouth will declare your praise. For you have no delight in sacrifice. If I were to give a burnt offering, you would not be pleased. Sacrifice acceptable to God is a broken spirit, a broken and contrite heart of God, you will not despise. The word of God for us, the people of God.
Thanks be to God.
Have you ever been busted? You know, where you've done something wrong, you thought you got away with it, and then you got caught. It's ascribed to David, and is said to have been written after he was busted by Nathan the prophet. You see, David had slept with Bathsheba, gotten her pregnant, and then had her husband, Uriah the Hittite, killed. And he thought he had gotten away with it. He even brought Bathsheba into his house to be his wife. But then God sent Nathan the prophet to let David know that he had been busted. God knew what he had done, and he had been caught. I think we can all identify with David. We've probably all done something, especially when we were children or teenagers, that we thought we got away with, and then we got busted. Being found out causes us to feel guilt, which none likes, but is good because it can lead us to repentance and to turn from our ways that aren't right. Now, I've often wondered if David would have been contrite and repentant if he hadn't been called on the carpet by Nathan. Would he have sought forgiveness if he hadn't been busted? We'll never know, but I think it bears thinking. Because there are things that we do that we don't get caught for. None of us is able to live a perfect life and never mess up. We all need to get caught because it makes us accountable, and we all need accountability. The thing is, some of our sins are internal. They're hidden so that we would never be caught because they have to do with our thoughts and our feelings. I can't speak for you, but I know I have unkind thoughts about people at times. I can be angry, even if I might not show it on the outside. And I can think harmful things that I shouldn't. Now, these are sins for which I will never be caught internal does not make them any less harmful. They can even be worse than those overt sins because we aren't held accountable for them. The problem is that all of these sins are not just against people that we may be thinking harmful thoughts about, but they are ultimately, as David said, against God. And they weaken our relationship with our Creator. So even these internal unknown sins are harmful and dangerous for us. Thus, we need to examine ourselves, even our thoughts and feelings, and repent for the sinful things in our lives that keep us from being the people God created us to be. And Lent is a good time for such self-examination. It might seem that focusing on where we fall short is harsh and not a good way to live. But looking at ourselves clearly can be freeing. It enables us to see our true place in the world. But we are not the center of the world. God is. And then we can understand that we need God. God who loves us more than we can fathom, to save us from our sins and give us new life. Now, in this psalm, David acknowledges his need for God and pleads with God for forgiveness. He wants a second chance, a new start. The amazing thing to me is that God grants the request and gives David. Now, David, if you think about it, has just broken all of the Ten Commandments in one fell swoop. Is forgiven by God. And that's wonderful for all of us because we have all also sinned. God wants us to acknowledge that we can't be good on our own terms to earn our way into God's favor. When we realize that we need God, God is there for us, ready to forgive and accept us, and to offer the divine love and grace God is known for. That is part of God's character. That is who God is. So today, we will be marked with ash. The ashes remind us that we are in the presence of the one who sees and knows all. Those ashes also remind us of things we like to forget, namely, we are prone to not perfect, and that we will not. However, God shows David, God loves us even when we mess up. And God has the power to make us clean, to wash as white as snow. And God will encourage us to come to God, to repent, and to deliver a new life. To return to a better way, and that is God's way. So in addition, the life, death, and resurrection of Jesus Christ, God made a way for us to spend our eternity with the Lord. So we no longer fear death. So even if we're mortal, that should cause us fear. God has made a way for us to overcome both sin and death when we relationship with the Lord. So I encourage us all to use time of Lent to evaluate how we live, what we think about, what we do, how we treat others, and what place our relationship with God has in our lives. As we do this, we should be able to see the changes we need to make and ask God for forgiveness and help in making those changes. Friends, the Lord is full of steadfast love and compassion. These traits are part of God's eternal and everlasting character. By God's actions, we can be forgiven, get rid of our guilt, and we can. God stands ready to create in us clean hearts and right spirits. Thanks be.
Dear siblings in Christ, the early Christians observed great devotion, the days of our Lord's Passion and Resurrection, and it became a custom for the church that for the Easter celebration, there should be a 3-day season of spiritual preparation. In this way, the whole congregation was reminded of the mercy and forgiveness proclaimed the gospel of Jesus Christ, and the need we have to to observe the whole world, self-examination and repentance, prayer, fasting, and self-denial by reading and meditating God's holy word. Let us now.